Welcome to an Advent Quiet Day personal retreat. My name is Karen Calafat. I'm the rector at St. Luke's in the Meadow Episcopal Church, which is part of the Episcopal Church in North Texas. I invite you to get into a comfortable seated position, maybe light a candle to sanctify the space. You've just been hearing the words of the famous and popular Christmas carol, O Come, Emmanuel. And that'll be in part our focus today, waiting to see how God shows up in our lives, how God comes to us. So the activities of today are built around the practice of Lectio Divina. Lectio Divina is a Latin phrase that means the holy holding or the holy reading of Scripture. So we'll be reading Scripture today, but not for history and content, not to learn something about the context, but reading with an ear to the holy. How is God's living Word speaking to us today? And the way Lectio Divina is practiced is the Scripture is read three times, and after each reading, there are questions that are asked. So you'll be given the questions, you'll hear the readings, and then there will be an opportunity for you to step away, hit pause on your video, and take time for personal reflection, dive a little deeper into the readings, and answer the questions that are posed after the reading of each passage. In your 30 to 45 minutes of personal time, you could write in a journal, you could color, you could go for a walk and just ponder the word or phrase that you've heard in Scripture. You could flip through magazines and cut out images or words that have captured your attention and create a collage around the words of Scripture that you have found. Perhaps you have your own spiritual disciplines using art or creativity to dive a little deeper with the Spirit. So when we do Lectio Divina, we read the Scripture through the first time and we answer the question, what did you notice? What word or phrase caught your attention? And then we read it the second time and answer the question, what did you sense? What did you feel when you were reading the Scripture? And feelings can be anything. Maybe you're curious, maybe you're happy, maybe it even makes you angry or uncomfortable or conflicted or confused. Any feeling is okay. And then we read the Scripture the third time and we ponder, we listen more deeply, listen with the ears of the heart. What might God's invitation be to you in this holy holding of Scripture? I'd like to begin our day with an opening collect, and collect simply means a prayer that we use to collect our thoughts together in one direction. So this particular collect is for Advent 3. Let us pray. Stir up your power, O God, and with great might come among us. And because we are sorely hindered by our sins, let your bountiful grace and mercy speedily help and deliver us. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. So our first meditation today comes from Canticle 9. It's sometimes known as the first song of Isaiah. It can be found in your Bible, Isaiah chapter 12, verses 2 through 6. Surely it is God who saves me. I will trust God and not be afraid. For God is my stronghold and my sure defense, and God will be my Savior. Therefore, you shall draw water with rejoicing from the springs of salvation. And on that day, you shall say, give thanks to God and call upon God's name. Make God's deeds known among the peoples. See that they remember that God's name is exalted. Sing the praises of God, for the Holy One has done great things, and this is known in all the world. Cry aloud, inhabitants of Zion. Ring out your joy. For the Great One in the midst of you is the Holy One of Israel. What did you notice in the hearing of those words? What word or phrase caught your attention? Surely it is God who saves me, for I will trust God and not be afraid. For God is my stronghold and my sure defense, and God will be my Savior. Therefore you shall draw water with rejoicing from the springs of salvation. And on that day you shall say, give thanks to God and call upon God's name. Make God's deeds known among the peoples. See that they remember that God's name is exalted. Sing the praises of God, for the Holy One has done great things, and this is known in all the world. Cry aloud, inhabitants of Zion. Ring out your joy, for the Great One in the midst of you is the Holy One of Israel. What are you sensing? What do you feel in hearing those words? Does it bring a sense of hopefulness, a sense of calm? Maybe it brings a sense of fear or unknowing. What is it that you feel around the word or phrase that caught your attention? Surely it is God who saves me. I will trust God and not be afraid. For God is my stronghold and my sure defense, and God will be my Savior. Therefore you shall draw water with rejoicing from the springs of salvation. And on that day you shall say, give thanks to God and call upon God's name. Make God's deeds known among the peoples. See that they remember that God's name is exalted. Sing the praises of God, for the Holy One has done great things, and this is known in all the world. Cry aloud, inhabitants of Zion, ring out your joy, for the Great One in the midst of you is the Holy One of Israel. What will you ponder around the word or phrase that caught your attention? How will you examine more deeply the feelings that arise for you? What might be the Holy One's invitation to you in this word or phrase or in these feelings? I invite you to take 30 to 45 minutes of personal reflection, journaling, coloring, going for a calm walk, and just focus on the feelings and the word or phrase that caught your attention, and see where the Holy One might be inviting you to walk more closely. I invite you to pause your video at this point and set a timer so you don't have to keep watching the clock, or come back when you finish the activity. Welcome back. I hope that your time away for personal reflection was meaningful. If you have an opportunity to share with a friend or a pastor or a colleague what the experience was like for you, it can make it even more solid on your journey. Our next meditation for Lectio Divina is the Magnificat, the Song of Mary. It's found in the Gospel of Luke, chapter 1, verses 46 to 55. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For God has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is God's name. God's mercy is for those who fear God from generation to generation. God has shown strength with his arm and has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. God has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. God has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. God has helped God's servant Israel in remembrance of God's mercy, according to the promise made to our ancestors, to Abraham and Sarah, and to God's descendants forever. So what did you notice in that reading? What word or phrase drew you in? What word or phrase caught your attention? My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for God has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is God's name. God's mercy is for those who fear God from generation to generation. God has shown strength with his arm and has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. God has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. God has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. God has helped God's servant Israel in remembrance of God's mercy, according to the promise made to our ancestors, to Abraham and Sarah, and to God's descendants forever. What do you sense as you hear that passage? What feelings arise for you? Are there feelings of hope and comfort, or feelings of discomfort and confusion? What feelings bubble to the surface as you hear that scripture passage? My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for God has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is God's name. God's mercy is for those who fear God from generation to generation. God has shown strength with his arm and has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. God has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. God has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. God has helped God's servant Israel in remembrance of God's mercy, according to the promise made to our ancestors, to Abraham and Sarah, and to God's descendants forever. What will you ponder as you take time alone to walk more deeply with the scripture? What might be the invitation of the Holy One in your life circumstances, and how this scripture might apply? I invite you to pause your video, to engage in art as prayer, or make a collage, write in a journal, or simply sit quietly, maybe with candlelight, and wonder and ponder what might be God's invitation to you through these words of Scripture. Welcome back. I hope your time away for personal reflection was meaningful. invite you to continue to move deeper and deeper with the passage if it continues to speak to you. This will be our third and final meditation, our third and final exercise with Lectio Divina. This one comes from the Epistle, the Philippians, chapter 4, verses 4 through 7. Rejoice in Christ always. Again, I will say rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Holy One is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known to God. And the peace of God, which passes understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. What did you notice in that passage that's likely familiar to you? What word or phrase caught your ear? Rejoice in Christ always. Again, I will say, rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Holy One is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. What are you sensing as you hear those words? What feelings surface for you? Maybe it's a feeling of comfort and hope, or maybe it's a feeling of not relating to this at all. Maybe you have fears and discomfort, and maybe you don't feel like God is present or close to you. What feelings surface? Any feeling is okay. Rejoice in Christ always. Again, I will say rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Holy One is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. What will you ponder as you go with your feelings, as you sit with the word or phrase that caught your attention? What will you ponder in your heart? What might be the invitation of the Holy One to you that speaks into your life and your life circumstances even this moment? I invite you to pause your video, to take 30 or 45 minutes away, to dig a little deeper and to listen with the ears of your heart as to how God might be speaking to you through this scripture. Welcome back. I trust your time away for personal reflection was meaningful. I'd encourage you to stay engaged with the scriptures we've read today. If one of them was more meaningful for you than the others, then by all means stick with that scripture. And sometimes when we get quiet enough and still enough to connect with the holy at a deeper level, it can be unsettling. So if something surfaced for you that you're finding difficult or troubling, please reach out to a trusted friend, a counselor, your own clergy person. You can reach out through the diocesan website here at the Episcopal Church in North Texas or at St. Luke's in the Meadow Episcopal Church. You're not on this journey alone. God gives us friends and companions all along the way. So please take advantage of someone that can help you if you're going through a difficult time. I want to thank you so much for taking time out of your busy lives and schedules to set aside some Advent time of preparation, a time where we sing, O come, Emmanuel, but we also take time to see how is God with us today. I pray that you will see God with you not only today and through the rest of the Advent season, but that you will see God with you through Christmas and into the new year. I'd like to close now in prayer and wish you peace on the rest of your day. Let us pray. Purify our conscience, Almighty God, by your daily visitation, that your Son, Jesus Christ, may find in us a mansion prepared for himself, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. May the Sun of righteousness shine upon you and scatter the darkness from before your path. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Creator, the Redeemer, and the Life-Giver rest upon you this moment and remain with you always. Amen.